Former Finance Minister Jose Mario Vaz, candidate of the dominant party African Party for the Independence of Guinea and Cape Verde (PAIGC), secured more than 40% of the vote in the first round. And in the runoff he faces Nuno Gomes Nabiam, an independent candidate backed by the army and the country's Balanta electorate. Nabiam won 25.14% of the first round vote. And the election is meant to offer the nation a fresh start after decades of instability since independence from Portugal in 1974. Its last vote in 2012 was abandoned after the military seized power between rounds of voting. And I am asking the army not to get mixed up in political matters and to remain in barracks, Vaz said late on Friday before a crowd of around 20,000 supporters in National Heroes Square. I am also asking the people to forgive each other and for nobody to spread terror in our country. And weak state institutions, along with its array of islands and unpoliced mangrove creeks, have made the country a paradise for smugglers of Latin American cocaine destined for Europe. And no elected leader has completed a five-year term in Guinea-Bissau, and analysts say donors and regional powers who have been bankrolling the interim administration are frustrated with the recurrent crises. And in his final speech ahead of the poll, Vaz said that he would fight to reduce poverty and pledged more investment in agriculture. Nabiam said he would seek to form a united government focused on health, education and tackling youth unemployment. And it's the beginning of a new era that needs to be marked by radical change, Nabiam told supporters. And security risks. And the final 2 weeks of campaigning in the country have mostly taken place in a celebratory atmosphere. And on Friday, long convoys of vehicles with the two candidates drove up and down the two main avenues of the capital Bissau honking their horns ahead of the final speeches. And both candidates have officially said they will accept the results regardless of who wins. But Dr. Marie Kibbert, an expert on Guinea-Bissau at Nottingham Trent University, said it was not impossible for jilted supporters of the losing candidate to attempt a coup. And much will depend on the reaction of their support bases. This is particularly true of the army if Vaz is declared the winner, she told Reuters on Saturday. And Ali Diallo, a 32-year-old mechanic, said he was concerned about violence after the results are announced. And I'm worried because Jose Mario Vaz doesn't have a great rapport with the soldiers, and that was the case with Carlos Gomez Jr., he said, referring to the PAIGC candidate who was tipped to win the last presidential election before an army intervention. And police sources said that around 5,000 men made up of police and forces drawn from the Economic Community of West African States had been deployed since Friday to provide security until the results are announced. And they said the army had been forbidden from mobilizing on the day of the vote. And Jose Ramos Horta, UN Special Representative in Guinea-Bissau, said he was cautiously optimistic about the result. And there is awareness in the country, even amongst the soldiers, that things must change in the country, he told reporters last week. And writing by Emma Farge, editing by David Gregory.